Look at that big man go.
Well, it's running on, I ran the gas out of it at the end of last year, so it's fine, but the only gas I have is the gas from last year, so it's kind of spoiled, so it's not running right.
No, you need to say that. You need to say that. No.
Well, guys, not much of a vlog today. It was kind of a lazy day, just hanging out, and spent most of it outside, so it's starting to feel good that it's warming up outside. The sun's feeling good, so it's a little bit nice to, you know, be outside for a change, so been spending a lot of time outside. As for my interview tomorrow, I've been reading some stuff online from other people who have interviewed for that same position of a Class A driver for Lowe's, and I've seen several places where it mentions a DOT medical card. It just seems like there's a lot of things building up to point towards the direction that this probably is not going to happen. I am not willing to go get a DOT medical card. That's one of the reasons why I left over-the-road trucking, is the feds are just... over-regulating trucking to the point where they're just over-regulating and driving drivers out of jobs. My dad was an over-the-road trucker for a lot of years, and he was a big old fat guy, and he died at 53. He was an unhealthy guy, had high blood pressure the whole time and all kinds of nonsense. But he was one of those diehard, highway bandits that just kind of lived and breathed trucking, Some of the best truck drivers there are, some of the most profitable truck drivers are those old, fat, unhealthy guys that probably won't live a long time. I understand it's not good to have a driver have a heart attack while driving an 80,000-pound vehicle down the highway at 70 miles an hour, but, how often does that really happen? But anyways, I just don't want to have all that federal regulation on my back. That's why I was asked several times to get a hazmat endorsement, and I just refused. I don't care if they paid $10,000 a day. I wouldn't do it. I don't want that federal target right on my back. It's bad enough as a regular over-the-road driver. They'll get you for anything, but it's even worse with crap like that. And the fines pretty much triple whenever you have hazmat. But anyways, so I guess the two main things now are, if they won't give two consecutive days off and if they require a DOT medical card, I will not take the job. I really don't understand why they would require a DOT medical card. The federal regulation stipulates the only time you need a DOT medical card to drive commercially is if you participate in interstate commerce more than 150 miles away from your home. There's not going to be a time where the Lebanon, Missouri Lowe's delivers something over 150 miles away. There would be a Lowe's store closer than that. So I don't, you know, I don't understand why Lowe's would require something that they're not legally required to have. You know, other than they're a large corporation, but it still doesn't benefit them at all. Maybe something to do with insurance or something, maybe. But other than that, it wouldn't benefit them at all requiring something that's not by law required. That's the only reason why I even contemplated taking a local driving job was because I would not have to have a DOT medical card. The last time I got certified was, you know, a few years ago, and they didn't want to give me a full 2-year medical card. They wanted to only give me a 6-month certification because I had larger than an 18-inch neck. You know, I'm a large frame guy. I'm fat now, but when I was younger, you know, even 20, 21 years old, I weighed 208 pounds. You know, I wasn't fat. I'm just a large frame guy. Always have been. I've got the high, you know, football player shoulders and all that kind of stuff. And my neck has always been big, you know. When I first started driving, I weighed 218 pounds. And my neck was 17 and 3 quarters inches when the first time I got a DOT medical card. And I got a full 2-year certification then. But then they come out with all this sleep apnea crap where they're getting all the drivers. You know, that's one of the things about having a large neck. If you have larger than either a 17 or an 18-inch neck, you automatically have to be tested for sleep apnea. And the catch-22 of that is I've never heard of anyone, not even one time, being tested for sleep apnea that did not have it. Every single time someone that I've heard of was tested, they failed. I'm under the belief that pretty much everybody, and the sleep apnea, if you don't know, is like you stop breathing for short periods of time while you're asleep. I'm pretty sure that happens to most everyone, but maybe there's like a certain range where it's acceptable or not acceptable. I don't know, but I wouldn't care what they said. I don't want to have to wear some gaudy like gas mask while I'm trying to sleep. It's not going to happen. I won't do it. So, long story short, I'm going to go in there tomorrow, you know, do my best to try and get on there. But if they violate either one of those two things, either not wanting to give 2 consecutive days off, which for a store employee, I know that they have a hard time getting 2 consecutive days off, but as a Class A driver, not a delivery driver for Lowe's that's like, you know, delivering appliances in a box truck. Not that. That's not what I would be doing. I would be driving the, you know, the semi-truck, single-axle, 48-foot flatbed trailer, you know, delivering lumber and blocks and all kinds of stuff with that, with the forklift on the back end. So, you know, basically a medium-sized, you know, semi-truck, not a box truck. They've got, you know, regular 10-speed, you know, probably eating fuller, transmissions, and just like a semi truck. So, but anyways, so those guys, the Class A drivers of the flatbeds, usually get, in the summertime they get overtime, but they usually get two consecutive days off. They're kind of like separated from the other Lowe's employees somewhat. But anyway, so if they won't give two consecutive days off, and or if they require a medical card, I'll just walk out. 'Cause those two things I'm not going to budge on. I'll just continue doing what I'm doing, and we're making it. I just thought it would be, kind of nice to have a little bit of extra money to have a little bit of fun with, and maybe get things going out at the property a little bit quicker. But I don't know if they if they screw around or on either one of those things, I'm not going to do it. So hopefully they won't. Hopefully somebody's just spitting something on the internet that's not, true or factual or whatever. Maybe that was specific to their store. I don't know, but hopefully they do not require a DOT medical card, and hopefully they'll give two consecutive days off. So let's just leave it at that. We'll end this vlog here, and should have some news one way or the other for you tomorrow on tomorrow's vlog. So I guess we'll see you then.